everyone, welcome. It's Sandy. I'm going to be trying to do my first landscape painting in the pour form. I've not tried this yet. I don't even know if it's really doable. I haven't really seen any videos online for it. I've seen a couple of videos a while ago where they did a few trees with a swipe. So I thought maybe I can try this and actually pull off a landscape, which is something when I first started doing the acrylic painting, I was always doing mountains and landscapes and rivers. So let's give it a whirl and see if I can pull it off or not. I just got a little bit of paint dust or something in there. Pull that out. Alrighty, so I'm going to be using lots of colors, and hopefully this video doesn't go on forever and ever, but I'll try and be as quick as I can. But again, it's my first attempt at a landscape. So what do I want to do? I want to do some sky colors, and I'm going to go lengthwise. No, I think I'm going to go like this. There's a sky blue. I'm probably put a little bit of green in there too. And a little bit of pink. That might be a little bit too bright, but let's try it. And maybe a little bit of the darker blue too. Sure, why not? Okay, so I'm going to first start out with that. I'm going to swipe with just a piece of plastic. Just an old laminated piece of paper, and I'm going to just try and get these colors to kind of look like a sky, if I can do it. I got some paper towel nearby to wipe it off. Just going to swipe again. Go this way and add more white into there. What I wanted to do was just tone it down a little bit, but it was pretty bright colors there. I'm going to take some of my white and add it in here. And go right across the canvas again. There we go. It's looking a little better. I'm going to try and go once more. Just to calm it down and maybe have a little bit of an effect of clouds up there. Okay, so now I think I want to do a little bit of a pearl. Yeah, a little bit of my pearl in here. And a little bit of my yellow, maybe. Just a couple of spots. Let's see if that will swipe nicely. Let's see. Once more. That's pretty awesome. Okay. So far, so good. I want to do one more little swipe here. Try and bring the yellow up a little bit, if I can. Oh, I want to do that. Okay, I'll swipe across it again. All the way. Okay, perfect. So now I want to try and get, just going to torch it and see if it's doing anything. The colors that are down there. That'll help activate any cells that might be there. Okay, so now I want to do a mountain. I want to do black and white kind of swipe, so I'm going to do, I'm going to be brave, I'm going to put black on here. I'm going to follow it with some white as well. Darker mountain up top, so maybe in the middle here I'll add some white. Okay, let's see if we can get a mountain effect. Starting to look like I wanted it to. That's a good sign. Okay, I need some more black. I have some smaller pieces of plastic, so I think I'm going to try that. Bring that up. Just kind of making the gray color that I was wanting. More black up there. Is it looking like anything yet? Okay. Hopefully that's not too much black, but I'm just going with it here. That pink's still showing through. I'm surprised it is, but it is. Okay. I have a little bit of a purpley, a dark purpley color here. I wanted to try and get a little bit of color to the mountain that's not just like snow like you would always see. Definitely kind of looks like a rock, side of a rock mountain, rock face. That's what I'm going for. So far, so good. Kind of making it look like it's got some valleys, grooves, crevices along the side of them, the rock face. Okay. I'm happy with that. Okay, now I'm going to do some greenage or something. I want to do dark green. Yeah, I would say dark green right here. With a little bit of black. Okay. Let's see if we can get I think I want to do a bit more black in here. I'll try and pull that black up with just my comb. Bit of a lighter green. Maybe this same green with a little bit of white. Let's just add a little bit of, so I think I'm going to go with beige. I just want to lighten the green in a couple spots. Just as a highlight. Let's see if that'll work. That's what we wanted. Okay. Okay, so now I got my trees in there. A little bit more green, I think, here and here. Okay. Definitely looks like layers and layers of trees. Thick brush, which is perfect. Okay. So far, so good. Hopefully this video is not going to be going forever. Now what do we want? I want some more greenage here, I think. I want to do some water too. So let's do some black over here, I think. With, I got some pour the already mixed beige. I'll try a little bit of that in here too. Let's do a swipe and see if we can get some more land happening, maybe. Or possibly another part of the mountain. Luckily for me, mountains aren't straight, because far from being straight right now. Okay. Just gonna bring the landscape together a little bit there. This needs a little bit of copper, I think. With a little bit more of this beige. Yeah, I'm pretty sure what I'm going to want to do. I'm going to want to go this way with it. Yes. Okay. I'm gonna make this more jagged. There we go. do something here. A little bit too light. Okay. Kind of lost my copper and all that, didn't I? Okay, let's go this way. Much better. Okay. Can't go wrong when you add copper, that's for sure. Running out of napkins here. Hopefully I didn't just shake up my video by pulling my microphone cord. Sorry if I did. Okay, so let's do some water now. I'm gonna do some blue. A little bit of my metallic peacock green. I'm gonna need a little bit of this green too, which is the evergreen. It's a little bit darker. And a little bit of my lighter blue. And I'll even go a little bit of my mint. Let's see how that swipes out. This piece. Just gotta love abstract painting. You can do so many different things. And with this pour paint, the fluid art, I just think it's so cool. And you can move the paint around as much as you can. And okay, that looks like it's pretty good. There we go. Wipe that off. Okay, so now I want to do some white. Oh, I sprayed up there. I'm going to fix that. Do some white there. Just I'm gonna give it some splashing of water on the side of the clip kind of look. Putting some movement in the water a little bit. Not a lot though. Just the illusion of it. A little bit more white in there, I think. Now we're going to be doing some more green. Darker green, some yellow. Let's see if we can get that to swipe out nicely. I'm going to need a smaller piece. Okay. Let me fix this little blooper here. Okay. Okay, we fixed that blooper, that's good. Oh, got more of a blooper in here. Okay. Now I want to do probably a little bit more greenery. What do I want? I'm gonna go with this darker green. I'm gonna go with a little bit of black. And with some cream too. I might have just wrecked this, but we'll see. Okay. Okay, so I want this up a little bit. Okay. Let's see. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. I wish I had a better brown. We're gonna go with bronze because I don't have brown. Okay, now it's starting to look like trees, which is what I was going for. The bronze is just gorgeous. Okay. Okay, now I need to do a little bit of maybe gold. No, gold won't work. Maybe just add a touch more. Where I think I need it. This I do not need in my water. There we go. I'm liking that. So now I want to do some more green and yellow. seems to be my theme right now. Spread it side to side and go up and down with it. Okay, so now I'm just going to do sporadic grassy areas, but I want a little bit more of a dark green in there too. Well, at least my paint's not drying yet. That's a good sign, right? Kind of make it look a little bit like a shrub. Okay, now I want to do something with this water edge, and I'm going to call this painting done. I'm pretty happy with it. I might want to put leaves up here. I don't know. Don't want to mess with the trees. Okay, water's edge. I'm going to go with copper. And some of the beige. I'm going to put some black in here as well. And I can officially say, by the looks of it, you can actually do a landscape with fluid art. Unless people watching and going, ooh, that's horrible. But I don't think it is. It's pretty awesome. Okay. What do I want to do here? Bring this copper down. Now, I think I just need a little bit more black in a couple places here. a little bit of white. I'm gonna take a bit of this white and add it to this guy. Make it look a little bit like a rock. There. We got another rock right here. And how about we bring one up over here? That's pretty good. Another rock in here, maybe. If I can get one. Yeah, I think one or two more rocks, and I'm calling it done. Is there anywhere I need to fix? See, my white fluid is starting to blend, so I'm just giving it another swish. So it's less of the white. Okay, rock, 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 those are all good. Tiny little bit. You can never have too many rocks. I think I'll give these guys a little bit of cream on it instead. Or the beige, I should say. Okay. Okay, so now I just want to pull a little bit of the green up to it look like the rocks have been here for a little while. Alrighty, now I'm going to try and do this without wrecking my painting, but I think it turned out pretty sharp. There we go. There's a landscape done with fluid paint. Thanks very much for joining me, everyone.